When you write a program in Arduino, you're actually using a combination of the C and C++ languages. Computers and microcontrollers, like our Arduino here, store programs in memory as a series of ones and zeros. Computers know how to read commands stored in this fashion, but it's quite difficult for humans to read and write. To make it easier to program computers, assembly language was created in the late 1940s and early 1950s. It consists of abbreviated words, letters, and numbers to represent commands. These instructions would get translated to machine code and then sent to the computer. The problem is that assembly was still difficult to understand, and each type of computer had its own assembly language. To remedy this, high-level languages like Lisp, Fortran, and COBOL were created in the late 1950s. They were more easily understood by humans and could be automatically translated to assembly or machine code for different computers by programs known as compilers. Between 1969 and 1973, the American computer scientist Dennis Ritchie created the programming language C while working on the Unix operating system at Bell Labs. Then, in 1979, Danish computer scientist Bjarne Stroustrup created C with classes, an evolution of the C language, which later became known as C++. C and C++ are still some of the most popular programming languages, especially when it comes to writing applications for microcontrollers. To begin to understand how to write a program for Arduino, let's talk about syntax. Syntax is the set of rules we need to follow in order to write a complete piece of code. It's similar to grammar rules in a spoken language. Let's open the blink example we wrote from the control flow episode. An Arduino program consists of letters, words, and symbols known as tokens. For example, the pin mode command has 7 tokens. Pin mode is the name of a function that tells our program to run some code written elsewhere in Arduino. The parentheses are 2 tokens that enclose the inputs to the pin mode function. The inputs, known as arguments, consist of the number 13 and output, where output is a special keyword in Arduino. The pin mode function uses these to determine which pin it should control and if that pin should be an input or output. Notice that the arguments are separated by a comma. That's another token, and it's how C separates parameters. Finally, we have the semicolon. The semicolon is a special C token which is used to denote the end of a command and is known as a statement terminator. The compiler, the program that converts our code to machine code, looks for semicolons to determine where a statement ends. It does not care if statements are on one line or many lines. We could write our whole program on a single line if we wanted, and this would work just the same. However, we recommend keeping it to one statement per line to make it easier to read. On a few lines, you'll see some text that's been grayed out. This is known as a comment and is ignored by the compiler. We can create comments with the slash asterisk and asterisk slash tokens. Start by typing a slash asterisk, enter whatever text you want, and then type an asterisk slash. Anything between these tokens, including the tokens themselves, will not be compiled or show up in your final program. This is a great way to leave notes for yourself or anyone else about what the program or a particular section of code is doing. Another way to enter a comment is to use the slash slash token. We can see examples of this below. Unlike the slash asterisk kind, these comments can only take up a single line. Anything after the slash slash on that line is a comment and is ignored by the compiler. In addition to leaving notes, you can also use comments to prevent a particular line of code from being included in your compiled program. Just put a slash slash in front of the line, and that line will be skipped during compilation. This is known as commenting out a piece of code. You'll notice that the Arduino development environment turns the text gray to show you that it is a comment. Next, we have identifiers. Identifiers are names we create used to identify or label a variable, function, or some other user-defined item. For example, pin mode, output, and delay are identifiers, since they are used to describe a function, variable, or constant value defined elsewhere in the program. Identifiers in C can be a combination of upper or lowercase letters and numbers. The only special symbol you may use is the underscore, so no spaces or at symbols. For example, my underscore capital LED underscore 3 is a valid identifier, but my space LED ampersand 3 is not. Some words are not allowed as identifiers. We call these reserved keywords. They're reserved because they're already being used in Arduino. Here are some common reserved keywords in C, C++, and Arduino. These have special meaning to the compiler, and if you try to use one of them as an identifier, you will not be able to compile your program. Note that this is not a complete list, but covers many of the keywords you will likely encounter while writing programs for Arduino. If you would like to read more about these keywords as they relate to Arduino, open a browser and navigate to arduino.cc. Click on Learning, and then Reference. Here, you can see a list of many of the operators, keywords, and functions that Arduino supports. You can click on one to read more about it. We'll go into more detail as we cover them in later episodes. For now, I recommend not naming your variables or functions based on any of the keywords given on this page. Back in our example Blink program, let's create a variable. We'll go into more detail about variables later, but this is a good example of using correct C syntax with a keyword and an identifier. In setup, below pin mode, type int space my underscore number space equals space 3 semicolon. Here, we've created a container with the identifier my number and told the compiler that we want to store integers in it by using the keyword int before our identifier. We then assigned the value 3 to our variable and ended the statement with a semicolon. Note that whitespace, spaces, tabs, and blank lines, is generally ignored by the compiler. I could rewrite this as int my underscore number equals 3, and it will accomplish the same thing. However, note that we need to have a space between the keyword and the identifier, as that's how the compiler knows when you mean to separate the two. Int my number without a space is just another identifier, and the compiler will throw an error telling you that it was not declared and it doesn't know what type of variable it is. In addition to using parentheses to denote the input to functions, we can also use them to define the order of operations for arithmetic. For example, we could set int my number to 2 times 10 plus 5, which would make it 25. Because C follows the normal order of operations, where multiplication takes precedence over addition. So, 2 times 10 is 20 plus 5 is 25. We could use parentheses around the 10 and 5 to make it 2 times open parentheses 10 plus 5 close parentheses, which is now 30, since the 10 and 5 were added together before being multiplied by 2. As I mentioned, the compiler usually doesn't care about whitespace except when it comes to keywords. That means we can put spaces between each of the numbers and operators to make this whole statement easier to read, and it will accomplish the same thing. The last kind of whitespace, blank lines, are completely ignored by the compiler and won't affect your program. If we added a blank line between pin mode and our my number definition, the program will run exactly the same as before. This is very useful for grouping sections of code together to make the program easier to read. I also recommend adding comments before each section to describe what that section is supposed to do. For example, we might want to divide up the code in loop into turn LED on and wait and turn LED off and wait sections. I hope this gives you an idea of what is meant by syntax when it comes to programming, and specifically programming in Arduino. Don't worry about being able to understand every piece of code you come across. As you become more comfortable writing your own programs, you'll start to understand what other people are doing as well. Also, the Arduino Reference Guide is a fantastic tool for looking up what certain keywords and operators mean, so don't be afraid to use it.